Everyone, glad to be together again. Let's take a look at Romans 12:21. It says, "Be not overcome of evil, but overcome it. But overcome evil with good." He probably says, what does that mean? It actually talks about that we should not overcome evil, because evil is a terrible thing that nobody can overturn. Nobody can overcome it. Nobody can even veto evil. But we can overcome evil with good. There's no way possible that we're able to take the government back by doing evilness. We can't do evilness. We can't do evil to get our point across. So I'll see you today. If you want to make one look great again, we must get our point across as good. Trying to make good points, trying to stay on target, trying to stay with God, trying best to stay with freedom. Will we try hard to be good and do good things and to share the truth, but don't let yourself be troubled by evil? That's what the whole message is talking about. They do not overcome evil, but overcome evil with good. That's the only way we can do. We can't, it's not this, we can't overcome evil. But we can do good deeds to overturn the evilness that's around. I'm not saying that evil can be overturned by doing good deeds. No, it's not about that. It's about to overcome evil. You have to overcome the evilness by doing good things instead of doing evil things. That's the only way we can find results and try to save your freedom and this nation. And bring us back to the ideal of one nation under God and keep our nation going the way it should be and keep it great again. Just think about that stuff. That's all we have to think about. Keep thinking what we can do for the good, not with evilness. Evilness will send you bitter and packing home. That's what it sounds like. Karen, don't be a Karen. Karen go out, says you can't do. Don't yell, scream, yell, kick. Let it first be heard, but don't try to act like a Karen out of it, though. Let it first be heard by saying, hey, I'm not foolish. I'm not going to wear this mask because of this. I'm not doing this to offend you, but I don't want to wear a mask because this, and this. It takes away my freedom, and it takes away my identity. Just focus, take some breaths, and you're like, who's cool, who's cool. Don't act like, ah, I don't need to wear this mask. I don't need to take this mask. You are wrong. That's not the way you should do. Treat us good and nicely and be kind. Not with anger, frustration, stress, and all that stuff. All that doing is just make them even more madder than you are. You make them even madder than you are mad. Make them offended, make you offended. Make no difference how you do it. The thing is just do it nicely to prove your point. And that's all. Because that's what God wants to do. He wants us to work in our lives. He never died on the cross for our sins. Don't need to be nasty. There's no need to be a Karen. There's no need to act like somebody that thinks you know everything and trying to kill people based on the knowledge and based on things that do not matter. Be a good share. If you don't agree with something, you don't have to agree with it. But you need to say, hey, I don't agree with this. It's not my forte. But I do not want to wear this mask because this. It's that simple. Of course, they probably have to keep out on you since you have to have it on because of the FDA account or that stuff. If they try to smash you down with those things, well, in that case, do what I ask. Put that mask on. Just do it the way you're supposed to. Not to make them any more madder. Because the more mad they get, more hatred they have for you, and they start hurting you, kill you, your easy beat you. Hurt you to the Pope. You if he take it out on somebody else. Don't let their hatred get to you. But don't let hatred expose the world either. Don't let it expose. But that's enough. But just do it nicely. That's all I'm asking. That's the same way with this. This is one to. It's not that Jesus wanted you to defend yourself, but he wanted you to be friendly and care, kill. He wanted you to be friendly and kind and loveful. Not hatred, no hazy-pazzy crybaby stuff. But that's enough to many those people. That's all that's necessary. So my brother says, but here's the play. Do Heavenly Father, thank Father, and Lord, Lord, help us to be lovable, kind, ascendant, Lord, Lord, don't let us be a Karen. Lord, help us to stand up for our rights without get offended and without smart people's minds into it, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for this day, Lord. Lord, just help us, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for done on the cross for our sins, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for everything. In Jesus' mighty name, amen. Thank you, bye. Make brother great again.